This is Dennis Sietsma, Dennis John Sietsma Productions, Homestead, Florida, USA. We're looking at a 1989 MerCruiser 3.7 liter MCM 470 and many other names engine. And I've got a coolant loss and I don't know where it's going yet. I have a new seawater elbow, which is the thing you see on the top there. I'm not going to swap it out yet because I want to figure out exactly where the coolant's going. In a prior video, I removed all the spark plugs and carefully turned over the alternator rotor the crankshaft is connected to using a 3/4 inch socket and a ratchet, and made sure that the pistons are not frozen and that there was no coolant coming out of the cylinders when I rotated it through, looking at the spark plug holes with the spark plugs out. I then did a leak down test and it was excellent. And I did a compression test and it was excellent. The average was about 170 pounds per cylinder. Overnight, I ran it yesterday, I let it sit overnight. And the coolant loss now is about half of the seawater elbow overnight from yesterday afternoon till this morning. But now I'm gonna do a combustion gas test just to demonstrate it. I'm sure it'll pass. I got this at Harbor Freight, but you have to remove some of the coolant first. So you can use like a turkey baster to suck out the coolant to make enough room, because you need a space there at the top. And they sell the tester and the test fluid separately. So you have to buy the test fluid and you fill it up to the line. And I thought there was something wrong with this kit initially, because I couldn't get it to aggressively suck through the and see if it changes color. But I had to be a little, hold it down and do that a few more times to get the squeeze bulb to work and see how it's agitating it every time I squeeze the bulb. That sucks through. And if the fluid changes color from blue to green, then I've got either a cracked head with a small leak or a bad head gasket. And we have a lot of problems with these four bolts. The gasket fails between the seawater elbow and the aluminum exhaust manifold on this MerCruiser MCM 470, and it's got a bunch of other names too, but it's the same four cylinder 3.7 liter engine. And I'm doing this repeatedly because I really want to be thorough. And if that turns from blue to green, or maybe yellow, I don't know which, whatever, you have to read the instructions, of course. And you can buy these kits online for combustion gases. And the reason you want to be concerned, this uses a Ford head from an old V8 truck engine, and I'm not sure the name of the engine. I hesitate to say, but I think it's a Ford 490. The pistons are very big, and it uses the head and the pistons and the rods from that engine in this engine. Ford made that for years. And somebody recently said even the flywheel is a Ford flywheel. But before you start this test, it's a good idea to bring it up to temperature. All these tests, it's good to make sure it's at the operating temperature of, could be 160. Yeah, there it is. 160, where the thermostat is. So that's what regulates. Everybody asks, you know, what temperature thermostat. Per the book, I think it's 160, per the service manual. And there's a bunch of service bulletins for this engine. So if you're working on one of these engines, go to my Facebook group, 3.7 liter MerCruiser, and pull down all the service bulletins and read them. And so far this is a good test. I don't see any problem here with it turning yellow. And the loss of fluid was like, it was completely dry prior to yesterday. And then yesterday I ran it for a while, and like you see here, and then overnight it was like half the reservoir. So, and only difference was I used water instead of coolant. And the service manual talks about using water with rust preventative, because this is an aluminum block, and so you need to use rust preventative, and it's a closed cooling system. If you use water as a coolant, and you only do that when you don't expect it to freeze. And I'm here in Southeast Florida, so it doesn't get that cold here. But I don't see any change in color. It still seems to be, it's not quite as dark as it was before. It's a little bit lighter in color. Anyway, hope you enjoy my video. Thank you for watching in my audience. And if you like the video, please give me a thumbs up if this helped you in any way.